Hi, my name is Leon. I'm 13 and I love football. I also have sickle cell, which most of the time isn't a problem, but I want to tell you about that one time. You know, in sickle cell, when you have a sickling episode, it's because all the blood cells change from being round to kind of sharp and pointy. And when this happens, instead of flowing smoothly throughout all the blood vessels around the body, some of the sharp pointy cells can get stuck in the little blood vessels and cause a blockage. The first time this happened was when I was younger. I woke up with terrible pain in my leg. It was the worst. But that's not the one time I want to talk about. You know when I said the sharp pointy cells can get stuck anywhere? Well, I mean anywhere. And that one time, they got stuck in my penis. Yeah, you heard right, my penis. And that day, when I woke up, my penis was already up before me. Nothing unusual there. It goes up, it goes down. A mind of its own. Usually, it goes down after I go for a pee. Except it didn't go down. Usually it goes down, but it didn't, and it kinda hurt. I had a shower, it didn't go down. I had my breakfast, it didn't go down. And now it really started to hurt. And I only had two choices, go to school or tell my mum. Yeah, I know, worst day ever. But she was great. She said I needed to go get checked out at the hospital. So I put on my baggy hoodie and I brought a book. When we got there, my mum spoke to the receptionist and we got seen very quickly by the nurse and shown to the room to wait for a doctor. She gave me some pain medicine and put some cream on my arms so that they could do a blood test. I got an oxygen mask. She took my blood and gave me a drip. I still couldn't read my book. When the doctor arrived, he asked me all about my penis. And I told him, it went up, it went down, it went up, and it went down. It went up, but it didn't go down. He explained that if you have sickle cell, this can happen. Because of the sharp pointy cells getting stuck in the blood-filled spaces in the penis. He said it's normal for blood to go into the penis. It's what gives you an erection. And yes, they go up, they go down. But if they go up and don't go down again, it can be a problem. He said it was a really good thing that I told my mum and we came to the hospital. I felt better with the painkillers and the oxygen. And my doctor said I was lucky because a little bit later, I could read my book. Yep, it went down. I had to stay in for a couple of days, just when my sickle cell started to settle down. And while I was there, my specialist nurse came to see me with the doctor. They told me this could happen again. Sometimes it will go up and down, and sometimes it will go up, but not go down straight away. Usually, if it happens in the mornings and it doesn't go down, when I empty my bladder, I should watch out to make sure that it does. If it goes down in less than 30 minutes, it's all good. But if it stays up for more than an hour and it's painful again, I need to grab my baggy hoodie and come back. They said it's really important that I don't leave it too long. The longer you leave it, the more damage the sickle cell can do to your penis. And we don't want that. So, that was that one time. I hope it never happens to you. But if it does, you need to grab a baggy hoodie and come to the hospital.
If you have sickle cell and a painful erection that won't go down, it's best to get it checked out. You should let your grown-ups know and go and see a doctor. If you have an erection that won't go down but isn't painful, you can try these things to help it go down. Drink some water and try going to the toilet to empty your bladder. Try some gentle exercise like climbing up and down the stairs or sit-ups. You can also try taking a warm shower. But if it's still erect after an hour or it becomes painful, then it's time to see a doctor. Let your grown-ups know and then get to the accident and emergency department at the hospital as soon as you can. It's important to get medical help as soon as you can because the longer you leave it, the more difficult it can be to make it better. If you need treatment, then just like Leon, you'll get some painkillers, a drip, and some extra oxygen to breathe, and it might go down. If your erection doesn't go down, then your doctors will talk with you and your grown-ups about what to do next. Each time you see your sickle cell team, let them know if you've been having any erections that won't go down or any painful erections. For more information on priapism, please visit the Sickle Cell Society website, www.sicklecellsociety.org.